Hi, I'm Erin. I'm a clinical herbalist and aromatherapist based in the Pacific Northwest, and I teach herbal aromatherapy at florinella.com. In the last video, I showed you how I make rosemary-infused carrier oil to use in topical blends for people who are dealing with pain and inflammation. And today, I wanted to talk a little bit more about how we can work with rosemary for that purpose and about a secret ingredient that you might not know of that helps rosemary work even better for relieving pain and inflammation. There are a couple of animal studies that have found that when you combine rosemary with clove, it actually has a synergistic effect, which means that it enhances the effects of each herb. So each herb, rosemary and clove, has been found in clinical research to have anti-inflammatory properties and also to have antinociceptive properties. Antinociceptive basically means that it helps to reduce your perception of pain and thereby relieve the pain. So it's not working in the same way an analgesic would necessarily, which relieves the pain itself, or an anti-inflammatory that relieves pain by reducing inflammation, but it helps to reduce your perception of the pain so that you feel a little bit more detached from it and thereby increases your tolerance for that pain and helps relieve it. So clove and rosemary have both been found in clinical research to have those effects, and researchers have tested multiple times the theory that when you combine the two, it enhances or increases those effects. And they found in animal research in at least two different studies that clove and rosemary combined had a synergistic anti-inflammatory and antinociceptive effect, which means they work really great together for reducing pain and inflammation. So I wanted to show you two different ways you can work with these two herbs to help you relieve your own pain and inflammation if these herbs are appropriate choices for you. The first thing I wanted to talk about is how you could work with these herbs internally. You could obviously cook with them, you could make teas with them, but one of my favorite ways to work with herbs is to use herbal tinctures. Tinctures are alcohol extracts of herbs. By macerating herbs in different percentages of alcohol, we can actually extract some of those therapeutic constituents in the herbs into the alcohol, which gives you an herbal tincture that you could then dilute in juice or water so that you could take that as needed throughout the day. It's a way of taking herbs that is a little bit more convenient than making tea would be if you're on the go a lot and you need something that is quick and easy. For this reason, a lot of people prefer to take tinctures rather than teas. Teas are great too, but tinctures are particularly effective. I have two here. These are both made available by a company called Herb Farm, P-H-A-R-M, and they're based in Oregon. They're a great company and they have a wide variety of different herbal tinctures on their website. If you wanted to take these via tincture, you could just add a dropper full of the rosemary tincture and a few drops of the clove tincture to a cup of water and drink that. And that would be adequate for an average sized adult without any contraindications or herb drug interactions. You'd want to check for those obviously before working with any herb, especially something that you're taking internally. You could also blend the two in an empty dropper bottle. This is a 1 ounce glass dropper bottle. Amber glass helps to protect the constituents in your tincture from light, which can degrade your preparation more quickly. So using amber glass is something that herbalists like to do to help prolong the shelf life and the integrity of our remedies. So if you were going to do that, you would want your blend to be mostly rosemary tincture with just a little bit of clove tincture added. Clove is pretty strong. You don't want to take too much of it, or it can have some nasty side effects. But in small amounts, it's completely fine for people who don't have any contraindications. The other way I want to show you how to work with this is to make a topical remedy that you could apply to the skin to help relieve pain and inflammation in your muscle and your musculoskeletal system. This is a bit of that rosemary infused oil that we made in the last video. And I've just filled a 10 ml roller bottle with a bit of that. So I'm going to use this as the base for my blend. You might remember in the last video that we talked about how rosemary can help relieve pain and inflammation, and rosemary infused oil makes a great carrier for blends that we're creating for this purpose. So I'm using rosemary infused carrier oil here. I'm also going to add a bit of rosemary essential oil. And rosemary essential oil comes in a few different chemotypes. The kind that you'll want to look for this particular recipe is rosemary chemotype verbenone. This is a constituent that is especially effective at helping to relieve inflammation and pain. Some of the other chemotypes can also be used in aromatherapy, but they're better suited to different things. And the verbenone chemotype is my favorite for topical use blends for relieving pain and inflammation. So this is a 10 ml roller bottle, which means that it is a third of about an ounce. So if you're used to calculating essential oil dilutions by the ounce or the 30 ml, then you'll want to divide that by 3 to get your appropriate dilution rate. So for 1 ounce or 30 mils of carrier oil, a 1% dilution would be about 6 drops total of essential oil. Divide that by 3, and a 1% dilution in a 10 ml bottle would be 2 drops of essential oil. A 0.5% dilution would be 1 drop of essential oil in a blend like this. We're going to make a blend at a 2% total dilution, which means that in a 1 ounce bottle, we would have 10 to 12 total drops of essential oil. And in this bottle, we're going to have 3 to 4 total. The first thing I'm going to do is add 1 drop of this rosemary chemotype verbenone essential oil to my bottle. Then I'm going to add 1 drop of the clove essential oil. Clove essential oil contains some constituents that can be really skin irritating. You don't want to apply it to skin that is damaged or irritated or overly sensitive. And you want to make sure that you stick to a dilution rate for topical use of 0.5% or less. In this bottle, that means we can put no more than 1 drop of clove essential oil. So I'm going to go ahead and add that to my bottle, just the 1 drop. Then I'm going to add a really fun ingredient that also has anti-inflammatory effects and is effective at helping to relieve pain and inflammation. And this is German chamomile essential oil, which has a really beautiful, rich blue color that comes from a constituent called chamazulene. And that occurs in our essential oil as a result of an interaction with a copper still and the presence of matricin in the German chamomile. Now, when we add 1 drop of this to our blend and then shake it up, it will add an even more green tint to our final blend. You'll see it in a minute. It looks really pretty. So once you have your essential oils in your bottle, you want to snap in your roller ball, put your cap on, and then shake this until you can see that that blue essential oil is completely mixed into the carrier oil. It doesn't take very long. So that didn't take very long. It's all shaken up now. You could see that the blue essential oil has been well dispersed throughout, and now it's this beautiful emerald green color, which I think is just so pretty. I love working with the blue essential oils because they can lend such pretty colors to our finished blends. But this is now a blend that you could apply to the skin to help relieve pain, inflammation, muscle aches and pains, and it's at a dilution rate that is appropriate for adults. If you want to learn more about clove and rosemary, those are two plants that we study in our herbal certification program at Florinella, and we also talk about more scientific studies that have revealed some of the therapeutic effects of these plants and about 100 others. And if you want to study more with us, check out the Herbal Aromatherapy Certification Program at florinella.com/herbal-aromatherapy. I'll see you in the next video.